guys and girls, here we are again for a very busy week of news with announcements of new games, but also encouraging elements for the PSVR 2 and informations on the Apple VR headset that I reserved for you in the second half of the video. However, it was also and especially the week of numbers, and we'll start by deconstructing them. Let's go! 60 will therefore be the first figure of this recap. We know that Quest and Quest 2 sold very well, with Mark Zuckerberg implying that a Quest 3 would be in the works and backwards compatible with Quest 1 and 2, which is cool. Except that until now, we had no figures. But here we are, we finally have something. 60 Oculus Quest titles have now surpassed $1 million in revenue, representing approximately 30% of the headset catalog. And such information reassures developers of the opportunities offered by the Quest platform and the usefulness of investing financially in the development of new projects with possible interesting sums in return. And Resolution Games has confirmed that this goldmine is very real. Since following the launch of the Oculus Quest 2, sales of its games such as Angry Bird VR and the excellent versus shooter Blaston have seen their sales explode by 500%. Please note that although they do not appear in the graph, Resolution Games has confirmed that January sales exceeded December sales. This suggests a long-term trend that bodes very well for VR, with games such as Bait, which offers free VR fishing and has been downloaded more than 4 million times on all platforms. In the meantime, we learned that Beat Saber, one of the most popular games on the market, had also sold more than 4 million copies. And if the game is regularly at the top of the sales charts in Sony's PlayStation Store's monthly download list, it's obviously thanks to the release of Quest and Quest 2 that Beat Saber has achieved such figures. In fact, the title doubled its total sales in less than a year. In addition to this, a total of 40 million DLCs were sold, which brought a lot of money to Facebook, which now owns the license and the big game development team. We will continue with the 100% figures, since Peggy Johnson, Magic Leap's new CEO, gave us some information at the Future Investment Initiative conference in Saudi Arabia. The second generation of Magic Leap, which will be commercialized at the end of 2021, will come with some notable improvements. 50% smaller, 20% lighter, and with a 100% larger field of view. But what does 100% more FOV mean? The Magic Leap 1 has a 40-degree horizontal and 30-degree vertical FOV. If either of these values doubled, then the FOV would be 4 times larger. So it is very likely that this company, with its great mastery of bullshit marketing, is actually talking about a 100% increase in the total surface area. And that we would in fact go from 40 to 55 degrees horizontal. A not insignificant, but not transcendental increase either. Finally, much less flashy, but probably much more important, Steam has just passed the 2% of users in VR. More than one player out of 50 has a VR headset at home. Steam's data being now much more detailed, it allows us to see a rather hallucinating progression of the Oculus Quest 2, which thrusts second place while it is hardly out. A great performance for the Oculus headsets in general, which would be in place with more than 50% of the market. We also note that despite its prohibitive price for many, the Valve Index is doing rather well as well. During a podcast on next-gen consoles, Jefferson, the project manager of Servius, who notably produced a very good Creed, explained to us that his team has high hopes for a possible PSVR 2 headset. According to him, the numerous patents that Sony has filed on the subject could, in his opinion, bring something excellent for the PSVR 2. New controllers, finger tracking, haptic feedback, as we can already find on the DualSense of the PS5, and a brand new patent has just come down, showing that Sony is still working on the project. This time, it presents an asymmetrical game concept where players on the couch will be able to influence the game in progress using cards on their smartphone. And obviously, here, the player may have to defend himself against zombies with a little spoon. More seriously, we see, mostly, a VR headset that seems to be wireless, which is great news. You have to know that quite a few patents are falling into oblivion with time. But Sony has released a good bunch of them regarding VR, and given the obvious success of the Quest, I can hardly see them depriving themselves of a market that is just starting to be juicy. What hasn't fallen into oblivion with time after being launched on SideQuest last year, however, is HyperDash, which finally arrives on the Oculus Store. This multiplayer shooting game from Triangle Factories offers 5v5 in the arena with double guns. Double the gun, double the fun. Its particularity is to propose rails crossing the levels in various ways to slide towards the enemies, but above all, to be cross-platform between the Quest and the Rift in order to find games more easily. By the way, thanks to the App Lab, you will now be able to test experimental games without the need for all the Oculus approvals and without going through an alternative store like SideQuest. But to get back to the official Quest version of HyperDash, it will be launched with 4 multiplayer modes and dedicated servers. And that's not all, since it will also be released on SteamVR in the first quarter of this year. On the other hand, we will have to wait until the third quarter of this year to discover the game Into the Darkness. This new independent title from Cosmos Games promises a fascinating story involving transhumanization in the near future. The title will feature an action-adventure game that uses a physics system similar to Boneworks for maximum immersion. The story will take place in a dystopian science fiction setting where humans try to move their consciousness into machines in order to live forever. As an agent, you will be sent to one of the research facilities with which all contact has been broken off and from which previous agents have never returned, to discover the dark secret of the experiments. You will then have to navigate through the environments while solving puzzles, all sprinkled with battles, but also platform phases. A game that is already quite unviable with what the trailer lets us glimpse. After Bloomberg last week, this time it's the turn of The Information site to let us glimpse some information about the future Apple's VR headset. And some fears about prices that were evoked outward last week are confirmed, since the headset would be positioned around $3,000. For this price, the headset would be equipped with more than a dozen cameras used for room scale tracking, hand tracking, but also pass-through to see your real environment. But above all, the headset would have 2 8K screens equipped with eye tracking and foveal rendering to avoid exploding the graphics consumption. However, in order to be able to blow up hordes of undead with more fun, on February 5th, a cooperative DLC for the shooting game Propagation VR was made available. If the single-player mode of about 30 minutes was totally free, you'll have to pay this time about $10 to make carnage in this abandoned subway station with friends, or with people you don't know yet but who have the same primitive needs as you do at time T. Please note that this update also brings the voice chat, so you can destroy the undead in a coordinated way. Here we go, that's it for this week. If you don't want to miss the next news recap, don't forget to subscribe and click on the bell. Thanks for watching, bye!